family basis, counseling, and parenting, what is working. According to our discussion, we were able to come up with a number of points. We noted that having regular family meetings with family members is good practice. And we have seen as one of the areas which is actually working, especially when children are going back to school or they are just coming back from school. Or if you have realized something wrong, probably has happened within the short period of the first day, with the family members, we were able to call for a family meeting, and we got this as a group of families working well. Extended family referral practices for counseling and guidance is also what we noted to be working, because sometimes you may provide counseling and guidance to your child up to their school. They don't know what to say anymore. But the best way sometimes is also to refer them to maybe an uncle or an auntie and inform other family members, because in that way they come in play and probably add comments or bring advice in the way, and they might be able to listen and start following new things already. Community religious involvement in parental education. We have noted that at community level we have religious groups that normally come to visit people at their family levels. And one of the things they actually do is to counsel and educate the children based on what has been submitted by the head of the family. Because they always get briefs from the head of the family, as they pray and interact and get to engage the family members, they actually have a little bit of what is going on. So we noted that this is working, and it can help us. Family members provide assistance to teenage mothers, especially shelters and independent probably teenagers. Stuck one or another, because we realize many times they do not have financial resources to even afford for their residents or even of the child being born. So you see that the current practice family members will be the parents, will be the grandmother or the father, and provide some time to manage or shelter support these people. Collective responsibilities in practice by some communities. Yeah, we have noted that it has been something working well, especially long ago. There was a collective community responsibility where even when a neighbor's child does something wrong, the parent of someone else can actually explain this child, so they can't manage the problem. Because it's not a very good practice. It's not a very common practice now, but we have seen that it's still happening in other communities. Challenges. Limited counseling provided to teenagers by mothers, by parents. We are most time actually not at home. So you don't get to interact with your family. That makes us that person and staff and counseling guiding. And it's quite a challenge. Limited opportunity for support channels for teenagers. Some of them get a second chance because some parents understand the situation they are going through and still continue to protect them, support them until they gain their full potential. But this is limited because some parents don't understand this. Once you get into teenage pregnancy and another related issue, that will be there. So we may not get the support and the support. Parents have limited time to develop needs. Children and therefore cannot provide the required social reproductive health education. I think this would have already explained. Inadequate parenting skills, especially on social reproductive health. We have also noted that the knowledge and skills how to pass this information. Sometimes we may not be able to package the information that we have. The medical advancement and control the information on social media, negatively directs the teenagers. Social media, I think, my was able to explain this narrowly. Best practices. From what is going on well, we call it best practices from being there, from the regular meetings, family meetings, very, very good thing. And if we should be able to make sure it should be supported and together. Community agreed rules, norms, being adhered to by community members. We have noted that in some communities, they are able to break rules and norms, and many members are asked to follow those set rules and protect and make sure that the teenagers are grown to their grooming children. Religious path, we also noted that this is the best practice by family. Based learning and counseling at school, we were able to identify a lot of positive things that are working, like senior human and men's teacher, is what is working, career masters, school based clubs, basically to provide the guidance and the professional messages to the teenagers, peer educators. School rules and regulations, because this is basically to make sure the adolescents and students are able to follow the right things. Effective disciplinary system and schools, because of this is help you as a part of the comprehensive that are working there. School health program, yes, because when we are able to screen the children, we are able to then identify problems that are drug related and probably them to that prevent their care. Coffee compounds, I think this has already also been mentioned. Challenges, weak referral system at school is one of the challenges. Low teacher to pupils ratio, one of the major challenges we've talked about. Poor sanitation and wash facilities. Schools, some of the schools are still in need of these facilities, and we think it's affecting the well-being of teenagers as we utilize these facilities. Too much focus on theoretical learning as a challenge, because in the event that you are faced with a challenge in as a teenage affected person, you can be able to probably innovatively do something that can give for you resources. But in the event that at school the teaching was so much theoretically focused, some of the things you can be able to deliver, and we thought this was a challenge. Some teachers are computers for teenage pregnancy, which is a challenge, instead of protecting the children against teenage pregnancy. Poor teacher pupils and pupils relationship. also noted that the relationship between pupils and teachers these days tend to be because more of an instructor and someone instructor and a follower, not necessarily a good relationship between the two. So this is not frankly involved with the right and shares and things that I feel so. Best practices we have counseling offered during assembly time is a very good practice and an opportunity that we can apply some and be able to counsel the teenagers. The admission of teenage adults at school as one of the very good practices also. I think this has also been explained from the previous presentation. Community mobilization and empowerment, what is working. Community dialogue and barrages is working. Radio talk shows and radio spot messages, this is working. Community livelihood programs, these are programs that are in the community to support all the different structures that also include the teenagers to make the house to support them during that period. Pastoral religious leaders visit in the community. This is also what I explained in the slides. Challenges, very high humanitarian expectations. Community members be mobilized and come to attend to the meeting that has been called. Many times they come with high expectations, and this is the challenge. Poor attendance when called upon for a community meeting. I think this is more prominent with the men. I think most of the community meetings when you call for you actually see the women come at the time. The adolescent boys. So poor. And disruption of planned community programs. We have noted that sometimes, because of conflicting programs, we get disruptions, and that is a challenge. Inadequate program focus on teenagers. Yes, even when we have community programs, actually, some of the programs don't necessarily focus on teenagers. Adequate information on child sex in the community. Thank you.